Hello, everyone. My name is Emily with the Rising Stars Football Academy, and welcome back to another installment of Hashtag Feature Friday, a segment dedicated to featuring different student-athletes and coaches in their experiences with our camps and combines. Now, today, we are actually joined by Mr. Kevin Gold. Mr. Gold is an NFLPA certified contract advisor, aka a sports agent, and the creator of the award-winning website longsnap.com, dedicated to football long snapping. Mr. Gold represented Rising Stars Football Academy owner Ron Johnson during his time in the NFL and have stayed friends ever since. Mr. Gold received his undergrad degree from the State University of New York at Albany and went on to Widener University School of Law, where he earned his doctoral degree. We can't thank him enough for speaking with us and sharing his knowledge of football from a business perspective. So thanks for joining us, Kevin. How's it going?
Thanks. Great to be here. I appreciate it. That sounds like a nice bio. I'm impressed by myself.
So I guess we'll start out from the very beginning of your career. So what made you actually want to become a sport agent? And was there any doubt as to what you actually wanted to be doing in your career?
So people can't really see me, but I'm about 5'6". So there was nothing I was going to play at a professional level, maybe a jockey, I guess, on a horse. But that really wasn't possible. So I grew up loving sports, knew I wanted to be involved in the sports industry in some way, in some capacity. And sports agent or representing those who can play seemed like a good avenue. So I went to a Division III school, so there wasn't a great opportunity to get a lot of that practical sports experience. So eventually I decided to go to law school and give the agent profession a shot.
What types of degrees do you need to do what you do?
I've been an NFL agent since 1995, so I'm one of the older guys. Back when I registered, back in my time, you just had to apply and they would let you in. Well, the NFL has gotten more restrictive on the type of agents they'll allow. So you basically now need not just a college degree, you need an advanced degree, which means you need a law school degree or you need an MBA or substantial experience. So when I was doing it, I just thought going to law school was going to give me an advantage. But in actuality, now, if you wanted to do it, at least in the NFL, you have to have that advanced degree. To me, having that advanced degree, having a law degree is really helpful because players run into a lot of legal issues. They need help with contracts, but they need help with off the field stuff. And having that law degree and really those problem solving skills are very useful.
And how long did it take you to get your law degree?
Most people do it in 3 years, and fortunately, I did it in 3 years. I worked in a law firm in New York City, kind of trying to figure out if I wanted to be a lawyer. I really didn't. I don't like lawyers. I didn't want to go to law school. I didn't want to be in a courtroom, but I knew that law school and being a lawyer was going to be a means to the end to get that education I needed to be an agent. So I did it in 3 years at Widener here in Harrisburg, PA.
And can you talk a little bit about some of the players that you've represented?
I seem to have a great connection to Shippensburg University. So it's not quite having a connection with Notre Dame or USC, but it still works. So my very first client to make it is a guy by the name of Rob Davis, who was a long snapper who went to Shippensburg. And that kind of started my niche of long snapping, which I'm sure we're going to talk about here. But I also represented John Kuhn, who's probably the most famous of the athletes that I've worked with. He also went to Ship. And of course, Ron Johnson did as well. So those are some of the local Ship players. In addition, it's been pretty much long snappers. Because of representing Rob Davis and because he was my first client to really sign an NFL contract, I started focusing on this niche of long snapping. And I assume the people who are watching this know, but a long snapper, their job is to just snap the ball on punts and field goals. And that's literally all they do. They play 8 to 10 plays a game. But every single NFL team, all 32, keeps one guy on the roster just to perform that role. So I've kind of had a specialty. I've represented players from Ship and from my alma mater at Albany, and then long snappers and some fullbacks along the way. So those are kind of my areas.
I was reading that you've actually, in the beginning of your career, you actually represented some baseball and hockey players. So yeah. How did you actually decide to represent football players and more specifically long snappers?
Yeah, that's a good question. So when I started out, there was no internet, there was no sports business classes, there was no Jerry Maguire, there was no guidebook to how to be an agent. So my approach was a very poor one, which is I'll just do the sports I like. So I was really into hockey. So I started working with some minor league hockey players just to get some experience. They weren't making a lot of money, but it was a way to get experience in terms of working with athletes. And then baseball is a little different because in baseball, they have 50-round drafts. So there's a lot of guys who get drafted. Now, most of them never make it to the major leagues, but I started working with some local Pennsylvania-based baseball players, again, just to get experience. Nobody ever made it to the top level. I think the highest was AAA, but it was just a way to kind of bounce around and get experience. And then what happened is I kind of started focusing on football, and it was really luck that I ended up with Rob. It was actually another Shippensburg football player said, hey, Rob Davis is a great long snapper. He's looking for an agent. I met Rob. He always jokes about it. I met him at the food court at the Harrisburg East Mall, which not the most glamorous location, but that's where we met and kind of started that relationship. And I was fortunate enough that he was my first client to really make it. And he happened to be one of the 32 best long snappers in the NFL.
And how do you go about choosing your clientele? Are you at the point where people are coming to you? Or are you still kind of out there searching?
Yeah, so that's the unique part I like, because I have a website at longsnap.com and I have a Twitter, longsnap.com is the handle. I write about high school snapping, I write about college snapping, I write about NFL snapping. Because I'm kind of focused on this practice, it's kind of unique. Most agents have to go get clients, right? They don't just call you up and say, hey, would you represent me? Typically you have to go out and recruit them. Well, my situation is a little unique because I've written about and know most of the guys as they progress from high school to college. You know, they kind of come to me, or I already have that relationship with them that they already know who I am. So I, again, if some of these kids win high school awards for their snapping, or I know them in college. So it's almost a situation where I've already identified them early on and they know me and we have that existing relationship. So it's a little bit different than a traditional agent's approach to clients.
And I think when people hear the words sport agent, they're like, oh, so you just get the guy signed. But can you talk a little bit about what all you assist players with, and like, what are some of the challenges that most of your clientele seem to face?
Yeah, so most people think it's just negotiating that contract and that's your job and that's 99% of it. In actuality, it's the opposite. Negotiating a contract really is 1-2% of the job. It's all the other stuff. And when you have a client preparing for the draft, they usually have to get training and they're getting ready for their pro days where they work out on campus, or they're getting ready for interviews with NFL teams. So it's all about preparing them so they're ready to make the best impression in that job interview with their NFL teams. Then when they make a team, again, the contract, if you're drafted, it's pretty simple. There's not a lot of negotiation. It's pretty much slotted contracts. So you don't get to negotiate too much either. Or if you're not drafted, it's pretty much a simple contract. So the contract part is really the small part. Managing all the other things, managing your clients' expectations, helping them with any off-the-field issues. You know, they're going to the Raiders, so now they need to get housing in Las Vegas, and they need to get family out there. And it's just helping with those kind of off-the-field issues. So the contract stuff is the stuff that makes the most headlines and is the biggest and most well-known, but it's really just a small part of the actual day-to-day job an agent does.
Being a sport agent or a lawyer in general is a pretty niche job, and you got to know that you want to do it to be successful at it. So what are the attributes that a person needs in order to be so successful in your profession?
You need to be pretty stubborn. When I started it, I did it on my own. So it was just me and an agent on my own. The logo you see behind me is my law firm, and now I represent players as part of my law firm, Pillar Auth. But when I first started, it was just me. And that's not a great way to do it, but there was really no other option. I didn't want to work for anybody else, so I did it and set out on my own. So you need to be really determined. Nowadays, you really need a lot of money, because the way it works now, which is different than when I started, is that if you want to represent a player in the draft, the player expects that you're going to pay for their training. That's their training to get ready for the combine or pro day. And they typically don't train in Harrisburg or Shippensburg. They train in California. They train in Arizona. They train in Florida. So the agent usually has to pay that expense. So the cost to be an agent is pretty significant. You have to be registered by the NFL, and that's going to cost you a couple $1,000s. You have to take an exam. That costs money. You have to get malpractice insurance from the NFL. That costs money. You have to register in all these different states. And then you have to get players and pay for their training and help with all those expenses. So having good financial backing helps, but really having determination and the ability to be rejected, because I was rejected a lot. And it still happens a lot. At the end of the day, only one person can be a player's agent. And in most cases, with most of the clients you're going after, there's in some cases 15 or 20 people competing for that role. So you have to have thick skin. You have to be very motivated and dedicated. It's a very tough and sometimes lonely business. You're out on the road. I'm 54. You're trying to relate to 21-year-old kids. So it's almost like my kids are that age, and you're trying to relate to them and try and convince them that you're the best person for the job. Sometimes that's hard, and the wins and losses can be pretty tough. There's a lot of important things you need to be able to deal with the ups and downs of this business.
And what's like one piece of advice that you'd give to anybody who's looking to break into this field? Are internships kind of the best way to get your feet wet and really understand that this is the business and this is what you're going to be stepping into?
I interned when I was in law school for a hockey agent. I should have mentioned that. I kind of threw myself at him at the time and just said, look, I'm looking to get experience, but it helps. Because I think people have a perception of what the business is like. I think it's better to get a real view of what the business is like. And the only way to do that is really get that experience. So I always tell people, do an internship. Or if you're in a college right now, if you're in a college that has a sports program, get involved with the sports teams. Learn what it's like to deal with athletes, because they're the same as other people, but they're different personalities, especially the ones that have talent. And you need to learn to how to deal with their highs and lows and kind of manage talent and their personalities. So get involved, get that experience, and then see if this is something that you really want to do.
Now, you helped to create the Patrick Minnelli Award, which is given annually to the best senior college long snapper at the FBS level. So why did you feel inspired to help create this award?
Since I started with Rob, I've seen the long snapping position kind of grow. Most people didn't pay attention to it. So I built this website in the late 90s. I wanted to pay attention to this position. This award was just kind of a natural progression. There's a high school award for the best high school snapper, but there is not a college award. And there is literally an award for every single other position in college. Mm-hmm. Quarterback, running back, offensive lineman, wide receiver, tight end. Heck, somebody even came out with the Holder Award before the Long Snapper Award. So about 2-3 years ago, the co-creators, it was Patrick Manley, who the award is named after, who's one of the best long snappers in NFL history. He was the first snapper to be drafted and spent 15, 16 years with the Bears. Another individual by the name of Chris Rubio, who runs camps for long snappers, we all got together and said, we need to create this award. And because we are so like-minded and so passionate about this crazy position, we were able to put it together. We started in January, and the first award 2 years ago was in December, and it was a live presentation in Chicago. We were able to get 250 people there live. We had to do it remotely this year, but I see it as something that keeps growing and growing. And our goal, really, honestly, is to get on those ESPN College Football Awards at the end of the year when you see the, not necessarily the Heisman, but you see those other awards for the best quarterback and running back. We want that long snapper award to be part of that presentation. So that's the end goal. But it was just a way for us to kind of recognize these kind of unsung heroes of football. And we thought an award to recognize the best college snapper was an appropriate step.
And as a Notre Dame fan, I would just like to point out that a Notre Dame player did win the first ever, so.
So the first winner was John Shannon from Notre Dame. Mm-hmm. Great snapper, great athletes. It's not just snapping. You have to snap the ball. You have to block, because there's usually like a 300-pound guy trying to knock you down as you snap. And then you have to run downfield and try and make a tackle. And John was great at getting downfield. Interesting thing about John, and why you don't see him in the NFL, is he voluntarily chose not to pursue an NFL career. He wanted the FBI instead. So he is in, I think, the Chicago area, but he is training to be an FBI agent. So he voluntarily chose not to go to the NFL and instead went to the FBI. So
I'd like to talk a little bit about how you met Ron and why you actually agreed to represent him.
Yeah. So again, it was that Shippensburg connection. I love anybody who goes to Shippensburg or Ridley, any of those Division II schools or even long snappers, they're always underdogs, right? And they usually have tough backstory or some situation where they had to overcome the odds. And Rod was a perfect example of that. Again, local kid, did well at Ship. I met him towards the end of his career, and I just thought this was another Shippensburg athlete who can have a decent career in the NFL. And he beat all the odds once again. He was with the Eagles. Unfortunately, had a back injury, I think, in the last preseason game, making a tackle. But he did get some NFL games under his belt, kind of beat the odds in that sense. But Ron is a typical client of mine, kind of that underdog with determination, who believes in themselves, who know they can get to that next level, and he did it against all odds.
And what were some of his strengths as a client? Like you said, is it the underdog mentality of, I got to do what I got to do to put the work in and to go out there and really perform?
He's what I tell anybody who's undrafted. So he went in and he competed against guys from Miami and Notre Dame, but he was a kid from Shippensburg. And you know what happens when the guy from Miami makes a mistake? No big deal. Go to the back of the line. It's okay. When you're the guy from Shippensburg, you have to be 100% every day, and you have to improve 1% every day. And Ron knew that, and he was confident in his abilities. And yeah, he was competing against other high picks or other high profile guys, but he believed in himself, and he had his confidence in his talent and his ability, and knew he would eventually, through that hard work, through that determination, through playing special teams, he knew he would get his opportunity. And again, he did it. He did beat the odds just getting there in the first place and then making a roster and then and actually participating in a few games.
And what is some advice that you'd give to current college players who do want to take that next step in their football career? Like, how do they go about finding somebody to represent them?
Yeah, so usually if you're good enough, they'll find you. So the agents do a pretty good job. They have relationships with NFL scouts. So if there's somebody else on the Shippensburg campus or somewhere else, they'll find you. But if you do have a motivation, I would tell you, don't listen to what other people say. You have to almost believe in yourself. I kind of view that my story is the same way, in the sense that I told people I wanted to be an NFL agent. They're like, why is an NFL player going to go with you? You didn't play the game. You don't know much about the game. You're just a 5'6" kid. Why are they going to pick you as an agent? And so I overcame those obstacles and kind of proved myself. I think anybody who wants to be a football player who has that belief in themselves, keep fighting, keep working to that next level. And if you're good enough, believe me, NFL teams will find you and agents will find you as well.
Now, you've been a guest at some of our camps and combines. So what is it like coming on pro day at the Rising Stars Football Academy?
I love it, especially that pro day, because I've had a lot of my clients over the years, Matt Johnson, who's a quarterback who played at Fisher McDevitt, and Bowling Green, who was in the NFL and the CFL. I've also helped bring some clients. I love seeing the kids react to the NFL players that come in on that pro day event. And I love what Ron has done, because I've been involved almost since the beginning of him growing this to where it is now. So it's great to have been involved from the ground floor. It's great because he told me one of the kids who I remember running around there is now in college and just got a college scholarship. So to see some of those kids who were, you know, 5, 6, 8 years old, looking up to these athletes and who are now on their own way to success, whether regularly in college or in an athlete in college, it's just, that's what the purpose of these camps are. And it's great that Ron does these and gives back and cares so much about the product that he puts out there.
What would you say to parents or athletes who maybe haven't attended one of our camps before? Like, what can they expect to learn or gain from them?
It's great. The thing I love about it, it's, yeah, you get the skill development, but you also get that personal development. So developing the campers to be strong men and women, that's also part of it. So you get the on-field skills. You'll get to hear from NFL players. You'll hear Ron's story. It really is a good way for children of all ages to get those important football skills, but to learn discipline and respect and get those off-the-field skills that are going to help them whether they play another down of football or not.
I'd like to thank you very much for speaking with me today and, you know, sharing your experience and knowledge. Yeah, I think the viewers will be able to take a lot from this discussion. And again, I appreciate it. And thanks for taking the time.
No problem. I appreciate your time.